Hey everybody, want to make another video here. And this time I want to talk about the meme that you may have seen that compares Sue Bird and LeBron James. In this comparison meme, you have the salaries of the two put side by side and the fact that they both won 4 championships and that they both have been in their respective leagues for 17 years. So we have these two comparisons being made between these two and then the vast disparity of their earnings. And people are putting this point up like this is something to fight for. And here's the thing. Comparing LeBron James to Sue Bird is like comparing the manager of a McDonald's with the CEO of a Fortune 500 company. You cannot compare the two because the businesses that they operate are completely different in scale. A lot of people are trying to compare the two because they both play basketball. But when you look at women's basketball and men's basketball, the markets that they attract are so vastly different that it's really not a fair comparison. It's not even an aspect of feminism. Because if you look at, let's say, it's not a legitimate inquiry for a feminist. Because if you look at their what their salaries are and you look at what their markets are, it's pretty much where they should be. If you look at LeBron James, all the notoriety that LeBron James has, his fans, his detractors, how much social media attention he'll get, the commercials LeBron James is in, the movies LeBron James can make. LeBron James has the kind of pull that the whole WNBA together could not have. That's why he's worth so much more than Sue Bird. Now, somebody might be mad about that. And the truth of the matter is that the problem with feminism is that it wants equality only when it wants it. So we can compare LeBron James and Sue Bird, but we cannot compare the markets that they operate in. We cannot compare the fact that people don't like the WNBA as much as they like the NBA. And hey, listen, I don't have a big problem with the women's game. I don't watch it, but I don't really have a big problem with it other than I think that leads to another problem here. And this is this. Men and women are not the same. They're not. They will never be the same. Sue Bird will never be LeBron James. And if she ever would become it, nobody would be able to complain, right? If the opposite was true. If there is a, and let's just look at something else. Women models versus male models. I am quite sure that there are women models who make way more than male models. Or if you want to look at different industries, even sordid industries like porn or strippers or things like that, there are things that women can make way more than men. And that's just the way it is, because men and women are not equal. Our appeals are not equal. What we want from each other is not the same. So to compare the two is to compare the apple to the orange. To try to make them equal is not the case. You can't do it. And I think that is really the big problem with the WNBA, because the WNBA has tried to make itself the NBA, and it's just not. When you watch, if you're like me and you like to watch any sport, I like to watch tennis. And the reason I like to watch female tennis and male tennis is because to me, they're different games. The women do not try to dress like the men. They have their own little style. And sometimes you'll have stars who are popular just because they're good looking on the women's side. And for the male side, you don't have that nearly as much. And the point is that they're different games. They have different appeals. And that's kind of what you should like about it. They're playing the same sport, same rules. But the truth of the matter is that they are different games because of how they approach them. And that's okay. And what's wrong with that? What is bad about the WNBA is that you will turn on the WNBA and for a split second, you'll be thinking you're watching the NBA. And because the people are moving slower and the game is not moving the way you anticipated, you say, what's wrong with this game? And then you watch it. Oh, it's a WNBA. And the problem is that the WNBA will never be the NBA. So why should it even try? What the WNBA needs to do if they really want to be successful is emphasize the things that women can do that men cannot do. They should make their uniforms more fashionable and feminine. They should make the rules of the game change to be more favorable to women. They should highlight things that women like to do. They can make the players more personable. They can do different things like that. They can make the game a little less physical. They can do things that will make women more appealing and make it more palatable to the average female viewer, just like the NBA tries to make its game more palatable. Well, Let's not talk about all that. But they should be trying to make the game more palatable to the average male viewer. So, hey, that's the reason. Don't get drawn into these false comparisons and this feminism. Feminism is just another word for stupidity.